Alexa, pause. Okay. You know how stupid I just looked listening to music, playing on my phone while I'm trying to do a video? That's how I feel when I'm teaching and you guys are. Nah, don't think so. I'm Eric Hurley. I'm going to be your instructor for this course, and I just kind of want to take a moment to talk about a few things, kind of welcome you to the class, not take up so much time that might be otherwise wasted time in class. So, you expect me to teach you, and I expect you to listen and learn. So, this is where we're going to try to, you know, we're going to kind of get together and find us an equal medium somewhere. So I have a lot of material that I need to get across to you. And when you're playing on the phone, when you're flirting and talking with others, you know, it doesn't work. Okay. I can't teach you if I'm flirting with other people or talking on the phone and this and that and other thing. And you can't learn if I do. If you do. Sorry. So, I'm not perfect. I'm not saying that I'm perfect. And I know you're not perfect. And there's going to be times when it has to happen. And that's okay. If you have to take a phone call, quietly get up and leave the class. That's fine. I don't know it all. And sometimes you're going to ask me questions, and I'm not going to have all the right answers. And sometimes I have to spend some time looking it up. But I promise you, I'm going to get back with you and find these answers. That's my job. I'm going to ask you to text me. My cell phone number is 828-446-7474. I would like very much for you to take a selfie and text me your name, the selfie, and what class you're in. And I know some people don't like selfies, and that's understandable, and I understand that, and I have no problem with it. But by sending me a selfie, I can understand who you are. Remember that you have one instructor to learn, and, you know, hey, this sexy face ain't going to go away. No, I'm just kidding. I have a hard time putting names with faces. Matter of fact, in the spring semester, I had a student that was with me for 16 weeks. And at the end, the last day of class, I'm going through roll and I'm like, who is this guy here? And he raised his hand and he was one of the few people that did not take a selfie and send it to me. And I could not. I knew him. I seen him. But I just couldn't put the name with the face. And that's all I asked. They won't be shared. Nothing. Okay. Abraham Lincoln once said it's better to remain silent and be thought a fool rather than speak out and remove all doubt. Obviously, he has never had one of my tests. If you don't understand something and you're too afraid to ask, you're going to look like an idiot when you come to take this test because you won't going to know the answer. It's okay. I mean, you're in a class to learn. Everybody's in that class to learn. It is not embarrassing to say, hey, what does this mean? It's okay. Because you know what? Old Junior over here beside of you, he's too afraid to ask too. And Sally way over here, she's scared to ask too. But she's glad that you ask. Because now all three of you know the answer. And it's okay. Don't ever, ever assume that you know it. Make sure that you know it. Take that time. That phone number that I just gave you is your connection to me. Anytime, You have a question, you text me. I didn't say call me, text me. Now, the reason I say don't call me is, well, I might be in a class. I might be on the road. I live in Morganton. I work in Asheville. I drive a convertible. Sometimes I got the top down, sometimes I don't. But regardless, if I've got the top up, it's loud and I can't hear. Sometimes I'm on a motorcycle. I can't take your call. Sometimes I'm with my family and I'm not going to take your call. But if you text me, I will get back around to you to answer that question. I promise you. Even in the middle of the night, I'm not going to say, I didn't say that I was going to answer you immediately, but it will be there in the morning when I wake up and I will read it and give you an answer as soon as I can. So, you know, learning is a team effort. I'm part of the team. You're part of the team. Your family's part of the team. I am your instructor. I am here for you to ask questions, to listen to the content, and for us to work together so that we can understand each other. Set up a time that you can every day work on this material. Don't put it to the side and then try to cram for a test. Cramming for a test only satisfies the test. If you want to learn it, you're going to have to be repetitive and reading over it again and again and again. My wife is deaf, and sometimes in class you're going to see me signing. And it's out of habit because when she's in the room, I'm going to sign to her. I'm going to sign everything that's being said, whether I say it or somebody else says it, because it's respect for her. For me to understand and learn to sign, I just didn't sit there and not participate. I had to sign too in order to learn that. So for you to learn at your best possible level, I expect you to participate. Please ask questions. Discuss. All right. It makes me feel good when students go out and they've learned the material and someone comes up and questions that material. They can answer it. They've got the answers and they have the evidence to prove it, to back it up. So, you know, make sure that you spend time studying, learning this at home, on the internet. All of my tests, all of my homework is on the internet. Okay, I'm going to tell you right now, I do not take up papers. That don't happen. You'll go to Moodle and you will do your assignments. If I require you to take a picture of something, to draw out something, then I want you to upload it as a JPEG onto Moodle and I will grade it at that point. Taking time out for yourself, I want you to ask your family to understand that you need time to do this, okay? Everybody loves to go to the beach. For you to understand this material and earn some extra money, more money, a lot of money, that depends on you. But in order to go to the beach, you're going to have to spend some money. For you to have a good paying job with lots of knowledge, you can earn money to go to the beach. So if your family wants to go to the beach more, they need to leave you alone. They need to bring you some cookies and milk. They need to rub your back. Whatever they need to do to help you learn this material and give you time and give you space and to understand that distractions are not good. I have ADHD myself and I also have dyslexia. So you're going to see me write some stupid stuff up on the board from time to time. But if my wife comes in here and interrupts me, then it takes me a while to get back going again. That's what ADHD is. You'll notice my door's closed. There's nobody in this room with me when I'm doing these videos because I want to give you 120% of my attention while I'm doing this. And when you're going over the homework, when you're doing the study, and when you're doing the processes, I want you to give me 120% too. So ask your family to help you out there. If you don't understand something, ask your peer. Ask the person next to you. That's fine. If you don't understand their answer, ask me. That's what I'm here for. So, as the old saying is, it takes a village to raise a child. It may take a classroom to understand and teach a student, and that's fine because I do not think the way everybody else thinks. I think the way Eric thinks. So sometimes people can understand something a little bit better or a little different way than I do, and they can get it to you. Now, here it says again, let's say that you understand everything and the person beside of you doesn't. Take the time to help them out, to help them understand that. Have study groups out of class if you have to. Go to lunch and sit down and have a study lunch or a study dinner. Okay? Take the time and work together to get through this. I'm not saying share answers and cheat on these quizzes and stuff because that doesn't help you. You got to understand the importance of what you're doing. I promise you, when you get out in the real world, you're not going to always have somebody to ask. You're not always going to have Google to ask, or Alexa, or whoever iPhones have. I don't know. I'm not an iPhone person. I want you to be able to go out and understand this and learn it and be very knowledgeable. I plan on doing my part, I promise you. And I'm only asking for you to do yours. Knowledge is power. Knowledge is also money. The more knowledge you have, the more power you have, the more money you're going to make. Is that not what this is all about? For you to make more money? Maybe, maybe not. Some of you may be in here for the knowledge. Some of you may be in here for the knowledge to equal money. But I promise you, knowledge is a lot more valuable than money. So again, if you haven't already, take out your phone, take a selfie of yourself, text me 828-446-7474. My name is John Doe, and I'm in the ABC class. That's all it needs, and I appreciate it. Thank you for your time. I will go over a lot of this and more in class, and I hope that when you come to class that you can be very comfortable in class. I'm not the square teacher. We're gonna have a lot of fun. Yes, I'm gonna pick on you. Yes, you're probably gonna pick on me, and that's okay. That's what, that's how we get along. I'm footloose and fancy free, but I'm here for you. Thanks, guys, and I'm looking forward to seeing you.